thank you. It is great to be here. Ah, and everyone looks so good. We've got to remember this. It's important, isn't it? Makeup, looking attractive. Something that used to be known as effort became known as a bit much for Zoom. 2020, what a fucking year. Before this shit started, I had a husband that travelled. Now I have a husband lurking in the spare bedroom wondering if I've begun my chores. Gotta be positive, haven't you? Gotta be positive. I think I found it harder because I'm a people person. I love people. I can't help it. I love people. I missed people. I missed the cleaner. I missed the babysitter. The babysitter's back. I'm so grateful. I'm listening to all her chat. I'm clinging onto her every word. She was telling me yesterday about Instagram. She said that she started expressing her vulnerability on Instagram. I said, why? She said, I realize I've been keeping a lot of stuff inside. What a fabulous place to keep it. You don't want to lecture the young, do you? But I couldn't help myself. Repress, repress, repress. Keep it all in until it gives you cancer. Should update that really to COVID. That's what they'll mark it down as. Got to be positive though, haven't you? The Instagram is subdued. That's a positive. You know, people are less prone to bragging at the moment. They feel embarrassed, don't they? People are embarrassed to boast unless they've got COVID toes. COVID toes, put those filthy feet away. Gotta be positive. There's a baby. Oh, I love babies. I love my own children in March. When I had my children, I felt the time sped up and I felt like I was hurtling towards death rate I never thought was possible. It's like bumping into a jihadi in a Christmas market. You don't think it's gonna happen to you, and then bang, it's your whole life flashing before your eyes. That's something we don't have to worry about this year. Christmas markets. I love my city, that's the thing. I love London. I can't bear to see what we're doing to my beautiful city. I know we've had our problems, but I love our city. I know we had a problem with knife crime. God, I miss knife crime. And I say that to someone that's lost some of my closest friends to knife crime. Some of my closest friends. Every time a kid got stabbed, another one of my friends moved to Brighton. I wouldn't say I'm middle class. I don't need to. And I think that's why all this hygiene theatre's confusing me, you know, because this is middle class role play, isn't it? And I am middle class, these are my people, I should be loving this. I love my people, you know. We know that there are different styles of wine, not just different colours. We like sparkling water. I love my people, and what's not to like about this virus? You know? What's not to like about a virus that respects table service? I even understand the masks, you know? Who doesn't want to muffle the mumblings of the staff? I get it. Just that I've been to the theatre. Goes on for fucking ever. I hate it. Little baby, crying. I've stopped breastfeeding. Don't panic. I'm not going to burst into tears. My small one's small as well. Won't think about him now. isn't that... That sound used to make me leak, even when it was a stranger on the bus. I saw a baby in a mask the other day. How we have fallen. Just stick a bag over its head and be done with it. The rainbow, it's really taken a battering, the rainbow. I saw an actual rainbow yesterday and told it to fuck off. Gotta try and cheer up. You know, I know everyone's had a different experience. They've had a different experience. I even heard that the raves have been fantastic this summer and the drugs are still superb. While I was squatting over a pillow pretending to lay eggs because my four-year-old's obsessed with a book about French chickens on adventures. You know, everyone hasn't had the same time of it. You know, I'm supposed to be grateful. Got a husband. I'm lucky to have a husband. You know, he's a successful guy. He's great divorce material. I've had that to cling to. To see the kitchen sink I've been chained to. It is exquisite. And we are happy together. We are happy. We are. We are happy. Mustn't forget that bit. It is pivotal to the jokes. The old ones. No, we are happy together. I think the secret to our success is he's a tall, slim, Indian man, fit, and I don't understand 90% of what he says to me. Because he's from Belfast. Do we have any Northern Irish in?
Yes.
Oh, you managed to escape just in time. Only one, that's good. You've got to be very careful around the Northern Irish. They're not like the diddly-diddly-dee ones from the South. They're gritty. People, they ask me, they go, oh, that sounds interesting. Indian-Irish, what does that mean? Obviously, it means he likes potatoes and he doesn't burn easily. Also means my in-laws live abroad. I don't think you can ask more from family than that. So. Family. We broke the rules. I broke the rules to see my family. My mother was desperate. She was desperate to see my kids. She says that they've given her a new lease of life, which is a shame. I was really worried about losing that joke in the spring, but it's still with us. By the way, I had COVID too. I'm not pretending it doesn't exist. I had it. You know, I had it back in March. I was ahead of the curve. It wasn't actually, I was just at the peak and it sort of goes off like a gumpertz, but not to worry about that. So I was talking about my husband. I keep calling him my husband. It sounds so possessive. He has a name. You know, his name is Sanjiv. Just I know it's very difficult to get right. You know it's difficult to get right because my dad still pronounces it Muhammad. So silly. People used to be really curious about our children as well, you know, before people started looking at children as vectors of disease. They used to ask questions. I remember being on the bus, oh, is your baby mixed? Yes, he is mixed. He's half fabulous, half really fucking annoying. I still remember moving in with Sanjiv, because when you move in with someone, you have the chat, don't you? I remember having the chat. I remember saying, listen, you have stuff, I have taste. Together, we can get rid of your stuff. And then you start planning the wedding, and I felt embarrassed planning our wedding, because it was going to be so big, obviously. And also because he hadn't proposed to me yet. He was still waiting. For the right woman, but what I did is night after night after night, I'd whisper sweet nothings in his ear. She's not out there. You're never going to find her. This is the best that you can do. And it worked. cancelled weddings again now. Cancelled weddings, haven't they? Unless they're in exceptional circumstances. Exceptional. What does that even mean? It means unusual, not very typical. What, like a fucking wedding? What absolute cunts. Oh, no, I wasn't talking about them. I was talking about us for going along with it. So, take your claps back. It's weird when you tell people that you're getting married. They ask really strange questions, like, are you going to take his name? No, what would he use? One of my girlfriends actually started sobbing. Is it going to be a white wedding? No, I'm really hoping Sanjiv turns up. She was uninvited. Always a few blue tick feminists with their opinions. Marriage is prostitution. No, it isn't. It is a lot better paid than that. So another lockdown. Oh, all the things we won't be able to do. Like go to dinner parties. Dinner parties, you know dinner parties? Where you go to someone's house, you have a horrible dinner and there is no party. We're all loving dinner parties now. We can't wait to get raided. How exciting. I keep thinking, maybe we were just bored. Is that what happened? We were just bored. Like, I keep thinking about last year. I should have realised there was a problem last year. You know, I was at my friend's house and she'd had her lawn replaced with AstroTurf. And her husband was missing, you know, because he was... he was hoovering it. And I should have realised then, you know, that if the media classes can convince themselves real grass might be dangerous, they can convince the rest of us of anything, but I didn't notice because I was pissed. So here we fucking are. At least I got to go away on my final holiday. Did anyone else travel this year? Yeah. Yes, of course we all did. But Sunday he didn't want to go away. He said, I can't get stuck anymore. I can't be stuck in lockdown. Oh, I can't be stuck, you know. He's paying for everything. And so I agreed. And he said, you can't keep talking about going abroad. I'm going to have a heart attack. Well, that made me ramp up the Googling. And I actually found somewhere called Durdledore. It's in England. It's in Devon, Dorset, one of the D's, all of the D's. And I pitched it to him hard. You know, I said, listen, here's the beach. It's exquisite. It's beautiful. You know, I said, you mustn't go out too far into the water, not above your knees, because a couple of people drowned there last week. Thank you to those people. God bless you. And he's not a strong swimmer. And I said, but you don't really want to go above your knees anyway, because it's cold, isn't it? It's kite flying weather. And he looked at me and said, but where are the beach bars? I said, well, you don't have beach bars in England, do you? You know, you'll be hunting for crabs. If you get really hungry, I guess we can pick up some chips from a local van. Anyway, by the time I had finished selling Durdledore, we'd booked tickets to Ischia in Italy. And it was wonderful. You know, they were doing some strange shit there as well. I saw a man in a boat on his own in the middle of the sea with a mask on his face. I thought that looks about right. But they were doing that thing where they tickled temperature everywhere you went. You know, not just my temperature, Sunday's temperature, my four-year-old's temperature, my one-year-old's temperature. I mean, Jesus Christ, my baby gets a temperature every time he gets a new tooth. What are you going to do if my children have a temperature? You're going to take my children away? To take my children away and look after my children for a week while I drink gin by your beautiful ocean. The little buggers sailed through every time. We were coming back through the airport and my one-year-old's just learnt to walk and this woman's suitcase just took him out. just crashed down on him. It was just there beneath it. Mommy! Hilarious. I only watched him for a minute before I rescued him, I did. And I rescued him and she was so sorry, but she didn't believe that he was mine. Because I said that we mixed, but we didn't manage to match. We mixed, we didn't match. What? One of our children is darker than the other, you know. Who do I discriminate against? I'm having to look to the BBC for guidance. Thank God for the BBC. She kept saying, is he yours? Is he yours? It's like, no, I'm just a Cape Crusader looking to save babies from your brilliant luggage. And then we're back, you know, I'm back, and the second I'm back, I start thinking, you know, who's benefiting from all this? You know, who's benefiting from all of this? Like, I know that the government gambled in the casino, you know, peak COVID, and they're still there, they're still in the casino, but who are they in the casino with? Am I Chinese? And then you think, no, it's more obvious than that. We all know who's behind this. We all know that there is one man that is making so much money from this and keeps saying it's about our health. And for some reason, we don't dare say his name, because when we say his name, we look stupid. Well, I'm not ashamed of saying his name. It is Joe Wicks. My friend keeps telling me nothing's really changed. I say, no, you know, nothing's really changed, but he's fucking stoned, you know. And the last time he said that to me, I really lost my temper. I said, you just told me you had a shit in your parents' garden because they were so frightened if you went into the house and used their toilet, they might die. What do you mean? Nothing's changed. It's fine. I had so much to talk about, but I'm being flashed. Other people want to turn, whatever. I didn't even have time to check my notes. I've got notes I didn't even look. I'm just telling you that they're notes in case anyone... I don't want anyone to think I have a tattoo, you know. Because I know everyone's got tattoos now, haven't they? I think it's because houses are expensive and we're all yearning to decorate. You've got to be positive. I'm going to leave on a positive note, you know, because it is positive, really. I think we're going to look back on 2020 fondly. I really do. I think we're going to... We are. We're going to look back and go, 2020, that was amazing, 2020. It was the year of the tomato plant. 2021, the year they come to vaccinate your children. The army, I mean. Just in case you thought I meant anyone nice like the local vet. We can still say no, I suppose, to all of it. And I hope that we do. Thank you very much for having me. I've been Tania Edwards. Good night.